Hello. This is the Cambridge Flyers Practice Listening Test, Test 3. Part 1. Listen and look. There is one example.
Look, Mr. Banks, my big sister took me to meet a famous photographer.
That's interesting. And you've got a photo of the day.
Yes. Look, the photographer had to take some pictures of some singers.
And what's the photographer's name?
Paul.
Can you see the line? This is an example. Now you listen and draw lines. 1.
Which one's your sister?
She's over there with the singers. Can you see her? She's brushing the girl's hair.
Oh, yes. Does she work for the photographer then?
Yes. Her name's Mary. She's worked there for a long time.
2.
And there's Peter. He works there too.
The man with the lights?
No, I don't know his name. I mean the person with the newspaper.
Oh, yes. I see now. Why is he giving it to the woman?
I don't know.
3.
And who are the singers? Are they famous too?
Yes. But I don't know all their names. Only the girl on the right talked to me.
And who's she?
Katie. I love her big watch. Can you see it?
Yes, I can.
4.
And there's William.
The man in the front of the picture?
Yes, he's looking for something.
What's he lost?
It was a comb, but he found it.
Oh, yes.
5.
Then who's the person who's sitting down?
The little boy?
No, the other person. She's got a cup of tea, or coffee perhaps, in her hand.
Oh, that's Jane. She's the mother of one of the singers. She came to watch.
It looks very interesting there.
It was. I had a great day.
1.
Which one's your sister?
She's over there with the singers. Can you see her? She's brushing the girl's hair.
Oh, yes. Does she work for the photographer then?
Yes. Her name's Mary. She's worked there for a long time.
2.
And there's Peter. He works there too.
The man with the lights?
No, I don't know his name. I mean the person with the newspaper.
Oh, yes. I see now. Why is he giving it to the woman?
I don't know.
3.
And who are the singers? Are they famous too?
Yes, but I don't know all their names. Only the girl on the right talked to me.
And who's she?
Katie, I love her big watch. Can you see it?
Yes, I can.
4.
And there's William.
The man in the front of the picture?
Yes, he's looking for something.
What's he lost?
It was a comb, but he found it.
Oh, yes.
5.
Then who's the person who's sitting down?
The little boy?
No, the other person. She's got a cup of tea, or coffee perhaps, in her hand.
Oh, that's Jane. She's the mother of one of the singers. She came to watch.
It looks very interesting there.
It was. I had a great day.
That is the end of part one. Part two. Listen and look. There is one example.
Mom, did you have a pet when you were young?
Yes. Why?
Because we have to write about pets for homework.
Well, when I was about five, my father found a rabbit.
And was that your pet, Mum?
Yes, but all the family loved it.
Can you see the answer? Now you listen and write.
Where did your dad find the rabbit?
Well, he went camping with my brother one weekend, and he found the rabbit in their tent.
And didn't it hop away?
No, it didn't.
And did your rabbit have a name? Can you remember it?
Oh, yes, because I chose it. We called it Horace.
That's a strange name. How do you spell it?
H-O-R-R-I-S. It was the name of a rabbit in a television program.
Oh, and did you give it grass to eat?
Well, it ate grass, but we gave it vegetables. Rabbits like those best.
Oh, yes. And what colour was it?
It was brown, and it had very long ears and a soft coat. It was very good at jumping.
And where did it live? In your bedroom?
No! In the garden. Rabbits don't like living inside.
And did you often play with it?
Oh, yes. Every day.
Well, perhaps one day we could have a rabbit too.
Now listen to part two again.
Where did your dad find the rabbit?
Well, he went camping with my brother one weekend, and he found the rabbit in their tent.
And didn't it hop away?
No, it didn't.
And did your rabbit have a name? Can you remember it?
Oh, yes, because I chose it. We called it Horace.
That's a strange name. How do you spell it?
H-O-R-R-I-S. It was the name of a rabbit in a television program.
Oh, and did you give it grass to eat?
Well, it ate grass, but we gave it vegetables. Rabbits like those best.
Oh, yes. And what colour was it?
It was brown, and it had very long ears and a soft coat. It was very good at jumping.
And where did it live? In your bedroom?
No! In the garden. Rabbits don't like living inside.
And did you often play with it?
Oh, yes. Every day.
Well, perhaps one day we could have a rabbit too.
That is the end of part two. Part three. Listen and look. There is one example. Where must Richard take each thing?
You've got a lot of things to take to town today, Richard. Do you enjoy working for the post office?
Yes, I do. And all these things have to go to different places. This is the largest and heaviest one. Look, it's a new bicycle. I have to take it to the hotel. It's for a boy who lives there. He'll have a lot of fun with it.
Can you see the letter B? Now you listen and write a letter in each box.
This looks funny. What is it?
It's a sledge. Let me see. Where's it going? Oh, yes, 14 Water Street. That's those flats near the boats on the river. I have to take it to a family called White. They live in a flat on the third floor.
I'd like to live there. And where must you take this one?
Oh, that. I think it's a lamp. And an expensive one, too. Let's see. Where's the address? Oh, here it is. It's for Mr. Cave, the artist. He lives above the chemist's in Green Street. I think I'll go there first.
And that's a strange thing to post. What is it? It's very big.
It's a toy dinosaur. It is big, but it's not heavy. The zoo sent it. I have to take it to the school. The children will love it, I'm sure.
And what about this one? Where must you take that?
Oh, yes, I mustn't forget that one. Look, it says important next to the address. It's a bottle of something for someone that works at the airport. Perhaps it's medicine. The address is difficult to read, but I'll find her office.
And what else have you got to do today?
Well, last of all, I have to take this to the hospital. It's for one of the doctors there. It's a postcard from his parents. I know, because I read it. They say they're having a great time and they don't want to come home. But now I must put all these things in my truck. Where are my keys?
Here they are.
Now listen to part three again.
This looks funny. What is it?
It's a sledge. Let me see. Where's it going? Oh, yes, 14 Water Street. That's those flats near the boats on the river. I have to take it to a family called White. They live in a flat on the third floor.
I'd like to live there. And where must you take this one?
Oh, that. I think it's a lamp. And an expensive one, too. Let's see. Where's the address? Oh, here it is. It's for Mr. Cave, the artist. He lives above the chemist's in Green Street. I think I'll go there first.
And that's a strange thing to post. What is it? It's very big.
It's a toy dinosaur. It is big, but it's not heavy. The zoo sent it. I have to take it to the school. The children will love it, I'm sure.
And what about this one? Where must you take that?
Oh, yes, I mustn't forget that one. Look, it says important next to the address. It's a bottle of something for someone that works at the airport. Perhaps it's medicine. The address is difficult to read, but I'll find her office.
And what else have you got to do today?
Well, last of all, I have to take this to the hospital. It's for one of the doctors there. It's a postcard from his parents. I know, because I read it. They say they're having a great time and they don't want to come home. But now I must put all these things in my truck. Where are my keys?
Here they are.
That is the end of part three. Part four. Listen and look. There is one example. Which lesson did David like best at school today?
Hello, David. Did you have a good day at school?
Yes, thanks, Mum. Maths was difficult, but I enjoyed art today.
What did you do?
We He brought in some leaves from the playground and painted them. It was my best lesson today.
And what about your hockey lesson?
We couldn't have it because our teacher was ill.
Can you see the tick? Now you listen and tick the box. 1. Which program does David want to watch on TV?
Can I watch television in half an hour?
Which program do you want to see? The one about the circus again?
Not that one. It's a program about storms. We're learning about them at school.
All right. And I must remember, there's tennis at 7 o'clock. I want to watch that.
2. Where's David's dog?
Where's the dog?
Perhaps he's outside under the trees, David.
Well, I didn't see him there. And I've looked in the living room and under your car.
Well, call his name.
Spot? Oh, there he is. You were right. He was in the garden.
3. What must David tidy?
Before you watch television, you need to tidy your things, David.
Oh, not again. I hate tidying my clothes.
I didn't mean your clothes. I meant your computer and school books.
Oh, okay. I'll do it in a minute. Can I have something to eat first?
No. Put that drink down and go and do it now.
4. What does David want to eat now?
I've done it. It's all tidy now.
Good. Would you like a sandwich and some fruit now?
Can I just have a piece of cake and some more milk?
Well, all right. But we've got pizza for dinner, so don't eat too much.
Okay.
5. Where's David's comic now?
And can you see my comic, Mum? It was on top of the fridge this morning.
It's on the stairs.
Thanks. There's a good story in it about living on another planet.
Well, let's sit down on the sofa and read it together. Then you can watch your program.
Okay.
Now listen to part 4 again. 1. Which program does David want to watch on TV?
Can I watch television in half an hour?
Which program do you want to see? The one about the circus again?
Not that one. It's a program about storms. We're learning about them at school.
All right. And I must remember, there's tennis at 7 o'clock. I want to watch that.
2. Where's David's dog?
Where's the dog?
Perhaps he's outside under the trees, David.
Well, I didn't see him there. And I've looked in the living room and under your car.
Well, call his name.
Spot? Oh, there he is. You were right. He was in the garden.
3. What must David tidy?
Before you watch television, you need to tidy your things, David.
Oh, not again. I hate tidying my clothes.
I didn't mean your clothes. I meant your computer and school books.
Oh, okay. I'll do it in a minute. Can I have something to eat first?
No. Put that drink down and go and do it now.
4. What does David want to eat now?
I've done it. It's all tidy now.
Good. Would you like a sandwich and some fruit now?
Can I just have a piece of cake and some more milk?
Well, all right. But we've got pizza for dinner, so don't eat too much.
Okay.
5. Where's David's comic now?
And can you see my comic, Mum? It was on top of the fridge this morning.
It's on the stairs.
Thanks. There's a good story in it about living on another planet.
Well, let's sit down on the sofa and read it together. Then you can watch your program.
Okay.
That is the end of part 4. Part 5. Listen and look at the picture. There is one example.
Shall we look at this picture now?
Yes. Look at the rain. All the people are wet in this street.
Yes, they are. Can you see the man at the front?
Yes. He's phoning someone. Can I color his telephone?
Yes, please. Color it orange.
Okay.
Can you see the orange phone? This is an example. Now you listen and color and draw and write. 1.
Now, what else must I color? One of the handbags?
Yes, if you like. Color the one that the mother is carrying.
Okay, but can I choose the color?
Yes, you can. What's your favorite?
Pink. I'll use that color.
All right. Would you like to write something on this picture, too?
Oh, yes. I like writing. What can I write?
Can you see the word shop? It's in big letters.
Yes.
Okay. Then write the word music in front of it.
All right. I can spell that. I'll do that now.
Good.
And can I draw something in the shop?
Yes. How about a drum? Can you draw that?
Yes, but where shall I put it?
Put it on the top shelf. There's only a book there now.
All right, and I'll color it purple.
Okay.
Can I color the mother's umbrella, too?
Well, let's color the other one, the one that the little girl's got in her hand.
Okay, and can I color it green?
Yes, that's my favorite color.
Is it?
Yes. Now, we need to color one more thing.
How about the envelope? Can you see it?
The one on the ground? It's getting wet.
I know. Shall I use brown? We haven't used that color yet.
No, use blue. Perhaps there's a birthday card inside it.
Well, it looks better now. Have I finished?
Yes, thank you.
Now listen to part 5 again. 1.
Now, what else must I color? One of the handbags?
Yes, if you like. Color the one that the mother is carrying.
Okay, but can I choose the color?
Yes, you can. What's your favorite?
Pink. I'll use that color.
All right. Would you like to write something on this picture, too?
Oh, yes. I like writing. What can I write?
Can you see the word shop? It's in big letters.
Yes.
Okay. Then write the word music in front of it.
All right. I can spell that. I'll do that now.
Good.
Three.
And can I draw something in the shop?
Yes. How about a drum? Can you draw that?
Yes, but where shall I put it?
Put it on the top shelf. There's only a book there now.
All right, and I'll color it purple.
Okay.
Four.
Can I color the mother's umbrella, too?
Well, let's color the other one. The one that the little girl's got in her hand.
Okay. And can I color it green?
Yes. That's my favorite color.
Is it?
Yes.
Five.
Now, we need to color one more thing.
How about the envelope? Can you see it?
The one on the ground? It's getting wet.
I know. Shall I use brown? We haven't used that color yet.
No, use blue. Perhaps there's a birthday card inside it.
Well, it looks better now. Have I finished?
Yes, thank you.
That is the end of the Flyers Practice Listening Test 3.